chuva pega. Tô chegando aí, bicho. Tô chegando aí, é de bicho. Pode parar com essa história de se fazer de defesa. Eu tô chegando. Tô chegando e é de bicho. Pode parar com essa marra. Pode parar do com
So, you've heard of going to Brazil, but have you ever thought of going to Portugal? I tried very hard to find a nice Portuguese song to play for the intro, but alas, I had to settle for Beta Portugal. I had to settle for a Brazilian song, but it's in Portuguese, technically, so it counts, Chad, it counts, and that's what matters. So the picture that you see is the Tropa de Elite. It is the Alpha Chads in Vegas, and they're preparing to go to Portugal, but we'll get into that in a little bit. I'm on time. I don't know why I'm on time. I can't wait until I can start gardening again so I have something to kill a couple minutes with at the start of each stream. Because it feels weird, just like I have my notes. It feels weird, just like jumping into things at the very beginning of a stream. Your stream's current bitrate is 11,000 and higher than the recommended bitrate. We suggest that you use a stream bitrate of 4,500. Okay, I can do that, actually. I had to reconfigure my OBS because chat didn't work last stream, so I had to fuck with it this stream to make sure that it works, and I think I can just reduce the bitrate. Perfect, wonderful, excellent, great. Everything works this stream. Can you fucking believe it? I can't. I want to talk to you, chat, my early comers of chat. I want to talk to you about a plague that I believe is sweeping the entire world. I think that we need the young men of my generation and the generation a little bit after mine need to be aware of this plague, which is it seems to be taking over the world. And I'm talking, of course, about aloof, disaffected older men who, for whatever reason, people my age want to look up to as father figures. It is something that I've noticed in the last couple months, and I want to talk about it with you guys. I realized that that the formula for becoming a daddy on the internet is to not give a fuck about anything, to sort of embrace this like nihilistic defeatist attitude where nothing matters. And I realized the reason why a lot of people are drawn to that and why they take on that persona is because it's real. Number one, it's really easy. What's the answer to everything? Just like someone asks you a hard question, like what's the meaning of life? You just come up with some bullshit snarky answer. Don't just say like nothing, man. You can't be a Debbie Downer, but you can't be serious about it either. Like what's the mean? Here, I'll do it right now. What's the meaning of life? Oh, to get pussy. You gotta smash box, chat. You gotta smash box like you're working at fucking Walmart in the back room, just smashing box all day. That's the meaning of life. Here, ask me your chat. Ask me your questions. Okay, I'll get to that. I know what people are gonna think. They're gonna complain. I already see it coming. I'm a box smasher. Smash box. Why are we here? To smash box. I already answered that one. It sounds like Sam Hyde. It sounds like a lot of people. You can, if you think about it, you can come up with someone. It's the current in vogue thing. Does evil exist? No, it's all evil. Evil is just fucking with someone else's thing. You know, it's like there is no evil. There's just like what you want and what someone else wants, and what someone else wants that you take from them is like that's evil to them, man. Like that's that sort of nihilist shit. You can just apply. You can take that anywhere. Just take it. You can take any question, and then with the most disaffected attitude possible, come up with a single sentence reply that is what someone could ostensibly believe, and the snark. Snarkier and funnier it is, and the less actually interested in that conversation it is, the more appeal it has to disaffected young men. And it is a thing, and there are many cult leaders who try to use this to convince people that they have an actual outlook when in fact they have none whatsoever and don't really know what they're doing with their own lives. This is something I've noticed, Chad, and actually I should take this picture off the screen. You might think I'm talking about specific people, but it is a vague, nebulous thing that applies to many more people than what you may think. So I don't want you to think I'm literally not talking about any specific person. So please do not take this as a personal slight, regardless of who you are. But what I think is that you have it's a defensible position. It's a super super defensible position. Because nobody can challenge you. If you believe things, if you have things that you think are dear and precious and that should be protected, then people can go after them. If you think that you should start a family, well, if you don't have a family, people will make fun of you for having a family or for not having a family when you want one. If you do have a family, people are going to make fun of your family because it's like, haha, you work your life for this family and look, your kids suck and your wife is ugly. Like, no matter, if you have something that you care about, people will attack it. But if you're just like, nah, man, I'm here to smash box, like... How do you assail that position? It's literally, it cannot be attacked. Because what are you going to say about that? There's nothing to say. It's a snarky bullshit comment that has no like actual gravity to it. So the would-be daddies of the internet see that this is something that's replicable. It appeals to a large demographic of disaffected young men who have money to give to their internet daddies for this surrogate fatherhood, and people can't give you shit for it. Because how do you go on the offense on someone who doesn't give a fuck, who just like acts like a retard all the time and has no convictions? How do you? There's nothing you can say about that. It's a perfect little fortress of solitude that people can come and visit and throw money at the steps of and leave. And you don't have to interact with them because you're too cool for that, obviously. You can't be seen hanging around riffraff. It might make you look bad in connection. But no, I'm not talking about Medicare. My opinion is that Medicare like masters this disaffected stuff, and that's why so many people try to imitate him, is that it comes natural to him. He really is just disaffected. He does not give a fuck about a lot of things. So when I like knew Coach Red Pill, he literally looked at the statistics for Medicare's channel religiously. He had like, I just imagine it on his computer, the way he talked about him, is that he had little bar graphs for Medicare's socials, like on his computer, like in some, like people would have stock tickers. He had like little graphs ticking on his screen for Medicare's numbers. And he's trying to analyze it. Like, how do I tap into this market and appeal to these kids so I can make them my own kids? It's like, but everyone, a lot of people, like they think, oh, if it's his laugh, it's his radio voice, it's like whatever. And they try to like mimic these little things about him. But the core of it is just the disaffectedness, and he's the best at it because he is that way. It's not a persona. So it's not a slight at anyone in particular. A lot of people do it, but I can't escape this. There's so many people who are just like, I don't want to be challenged on anything, and I want to make a lot of money. And so what's the best way to do that? Just be snarky. Just be a snarky dick. And have nothing that you actually care about. That way, nobody can give you shit for it. You can just laugh it off, and that's appealing to my generation, the Fight Club generation, the generation of men raised by women, who is another woman really what we need? No, I need an internet daddy. to make me laugh and to give me financial advice in the form of YouTube videos and Gumroad videos and shit. That's what I really need right now. I only care about anime. That's a popular opinion these days. I can kind of understand why. Like, I tried watching anime. I gave it a try. The last anime I watched was Lane Serial Experiments. Awful. I watched it in one sitting because I was like, so many people were talking about this show like it's a cult classic back when anime was good, man. So I sat down and I watched Lane from episode to episode, every episode, waiting for it to click and to be like, wow, man, this is like art and shit, man. I fucking hated it, and I've given up ever giving anime a second chance. It was terrible. If you want to know what Lane Serial Experiments is like, imagine photos of electrical wires and a dull buzzing noise for 8 fucking hours while a little girl stares at a computer. That is Lane, and it's fucking awful, and fuck weeaboos. And I ask that people don't be afraid to have things that they like and have convictions in, because it's not gay to care about things. It's not gay to be optimistic. It's not gay to pick sides. It's really gay to like shelter yourself from the world and pretend that there's nothing you can do to make your life better, because there definitely is. There definitely is, chat. And don't let e-daddies tell you otherwise, that the only thing you can trust in is Bitcoin in them. Okay. That's enough of my rant. I was thinking about this today. I was angry. I was chatting to my least favorite demographic on my forum, which is the people in the Ethan Ralph chat. And we were talking about this, about the, I don't know what they were talking about. I don't listen to them when they say things to me. I just yell at them. And I was yelling at them about this, and I thought, you know what, I'll probably talk about this on stream, because it's actually a pretty good thought. It's something that can put a thumbtack in and bring up later. You're our e-daddy. No. Just look, if you're going to look up to me, here's what I did. You ready? When I was, in fact, my advice only really applies to like suicidal people. Cause I remember I was a super, super depressed teenager. My teen years were not happy. I was not a happy camper when I was like ages like 13 to 18. That was a bad time. Okay. That was rough. And then I saw a comedy sketch, and I think it was like an Australian dude in America, and he had like some bit where he said like fuck me, I'm envious of suicidal people, because imagine not having to give a fuck. Like, you can do whatever you want, and then if it doesn't work out, you can just kill yourself. And I thought, damn, that's a good line of thought. I'm gonna go and do whatever I want. So I found a job. And I started hosting the forum pretty soon after that. And then I moved to Australia and the Philippines and wherever I wanted. Now I'm pretty content. Now I'm pretty content. So I have to be careful. And I have to kind of... I was very fortunate to never do anything like illegal. I never did anything stupid or illegal. So I'm in a position where now I can cement myself back in the real world. Now that I like stuff again. And I like my forum, and I might go back to the U.S. because I like guns. Now that I like stuff again, I can start prepare. I can settle down and stop being an idiot. But I'm glad that for a while I was an idiot and I did whatever I wanted. And people can give me shit for 8chan and whatever. I don't care. I had fun. Did you move to the Philippines and hang out with a cripple and a pig farmer at 2023? I don't think so. So let he who mingles with the pig farmer cast the first stone, chat. Sunshine and vitamins help. What are you, a roasty? I like to travel. I want to travel. I want to go someplace exotic like Canada. I want to go see Canada. I want to go see the snow. I wanna walk around in my UGG boots in the snow in Canada. True, but I'm also not fat. Too shy. Okay, I want to get Ralph out of the way first, I think. I got two Ethans to talk about again. Only a little bit of each. Though, I don't know, Ralph's stuff is interesting again. I hate talking about him, but I will, because he's funny. He's funny. Now that I have settled into a nice, comfy position in my life, I will live vicariously through Ralph, who is now ready to take up the mantle of doing whatever stupid shit he wants to. And I'm thankful for this. So Ralph decided that he always does this, by the way. He loves to call other people women, but then he does this bit shit where he starts vague tweeting like, oh God, my site's slow as shit. My site's been dysfunctional as fuck all month. I don't know why people don't answer my emails when I ask for help with tech stuff, but it's been operating more poorly than usual this week. Ralph says, I'm always astonished at the disloyalty shown by some people. It really is just incredible, LOL. And this is gay. I want you guys to know that if you go on Twitter and you just say something like, can't trust people these days, everyone sees that tweet, who does see that tweet, will think, the person who wrote this tweet is gay. They suck dick. Whoever writes a tweet like this loves it up the ass. That is the only possible explanation for why anyone would write a tweet like this. Thankfully, it was explained later who he's talking about. Actually, I think this is another vague tweet. Too busy planning events and making moves from my own house with my own vehicle with two successful shows. If I was a broke bum who was a complete failure in every way, I'd probably focus on that before I would an internet beef. Oh, and I heard about your little Discord cry fest a few months ago, you pussy. That's all you ever do, crawl into the corner and cry like a little girl. I'm getting too good at impersonating Ralph. One day I'm going to be playing poker like with the pigs, and we'll be squealing at each other, and people won't be able to tell which one's Ralph, which one's Josh. They're all the same now. It's too good. Discord drama. No, I guess Andy has his own Discord. He starts bitching about Andy again, but the point is, I don't know what Andy said to piss him off. This post doesn't explain it. Oh, Andy talked to Flamenco. That's why. Andy talked to Flamenco, and that was a sin. So now he's pissed off at Andy and called him a Judas. And then, of course, because Ethan Ralph is addicted to going low, and while May is still in early pregnancy, he says, I don't regret having my son, but I bet Andy Worski regrets killing his. And I guess Andy Worski had his girlfriend have an abortion. I don't know what the story is with that. I just know that he posted porn of his ex and also his sister. I don't know how that came out, but that's out there. So probably wasn't a good move. I don't know if he personally posted it, but that definitely got posted on Cal, like way back when IBS was like a thing. Worski says, the Gunt has said some of the most horrendous stuff about me in the past 4 days nonstop. I bit my tongue, but all right, it's done. Let's go. Hey, Gunt, you'll wish you had an abortion soon when Mr. Vickers repos your truck. Let's see. Ricardo weighs in on the drama. I imagine that ruffles Gunt a bit. Oh, well, I don't want to read their back and forth, but the gist is that Andy Worski is from Portugal. He is Portuguese. He lives in Canada. He has not been to Portugal in a long time, and he has been talking about moving back to Portugal for about 2 years. So, Andy and Sinead? That's not her name. Sinead? Sinead? It reads like Sneed, and I think you're fucking with me. Well, he doesn't need to be a father. He's just all about procreating. He has a very Darwinian sense of success. Sinead. Sneed. Okay, whatever. Andy Worski and his girlfriend Sneed had an abortion. And Ethan Ralph decides to poke at this. Even though I remember very clearly, by the way, Ralph had me on his show a long, long time ago. And he refused to make fun of Sargon's abortion. And I even remember I made a very edgy joke about stomping on a fetus. And he was like, no, 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 I can't co-sign that. Oh, my God. And he, like, took offense to it. But now the tables have turned, and he's over here talking about fucking stomping on fetuses and shit. And now that Ralph will sink to no depth to get back at his enemies. Anyways, he decides that he's going to go to Portugal. He's just going to up and go to Portugal because Andy Worski is from Portugal, and Andy Worski wants to go back home to Portugal, and I don't think he's been able to throw together enough cash to make a move, because it's, you know, it's a lot of money to fly over and move your shit and get, like, you know, rent and stuff together. You have to save up for that, and you also have to dedicate yourself to it, and he's just not done so. So Ralph says, fuck it, I'll one-up him. I have money to spare, I guess. I have money to burn before I have to start paying child support. Oh, you have to get a vaccine to become a resident of Portugal, which is why he's not done that, because he doesn't want to get the vaccine. But you don't need a vaccine, by the way, to square everything out before people start asking questions. No, you do not have to have a COVID vaccine to go to Portugal as a tourist. You only have to have a negative PCR test in the last 48 to 24 hours. And no, him being a felon is not a problem, because if you are a felon, Portugal is one of the few countries in Europe that will still let you in, but you have to apply for a visa ahead of time, which won't be a problem, because if you don't know this, Portugal lets in basically everyone. It's a hot spot for drunk British people to go and party on the beach. So Ethan Ralph is basically right up their alley in terms of what kind of tourists they try to bring in. So that's not going to be a problem either. So Ralph says, I have to burn all this money before I owe child support payments and court fees and shit. How am I going to do that? Let's go to Portugal. He decides that he's going to invite Dick Masterson, but he's not going to invite May. And I really stumbled on this for a while, and I was thinking, like, God, why could Ethan Ralph be going to Portugal? Like, what could possibly be going on there? So let's look up, are drugs legal in Portugal? Portugal decriminalized the public and private use, acquisition, and possession of all drugs in 2000. Is prostitution legal in Portugal? Selling sex is legal in Portugal. Age of consent in Portugal. The Portuguese Penal Code establishes the age of consent as 14, regardless of gender or sexual orientation. Very interesting. But I guess the Portuguese 14-year-olds working in the brothel addicted to crack cocaine is not a very serious issue, because America has anti-sex tourism laws, which means that you can't just go to Portugal for the sole express intent of fucking a 14-year-old at the brothel, because you'll get arrested in the U.S. as if you had done it in the U.S. And so, I mean, that's not an issue at all, right? Uh-oh.
Cronishman, I'll read that in just a sec. Thank you, Cron.
Is it gonna... Infinite slicks and $3, Ralph actually...
Let me give it time to buffer. You know how my site is. My site's nice and gimpy, so I have to give it a head start.
Cronishman, I'll read that in just a sec. Thank you, Cron.
Infinite slicks and $3, Ralph, actually there is a loophole around that law.
I don't care.
If you go there with the explicit intention to Worski a 14-year-old, yes, it's illegal. However, if you are going on Baka or a biz trip and happen to bang one, it's legal.
What?
Rikita told me this, BTW.
Rikita told you that? I don't even...
Asmaster 33 sent $3. It's always those goddamn key case.
He literally said... Did Rikita really tell you that? That's the part I want to know. I mean, I don't...
I don't doubt that your fucking ass would know that somehow, but I want to know if you're telling the truth. Makeda would know that law. No, you know what? I've talked a lot of shit about that shyster, and I'm sure I shouldn't even really cut him any slack, honestly, given the shit he said about me and people I love, but yeah, I don't know. I won't put that on him. I won't put that one on him. I won't put that one on him. He's a piece of shit, though, for many reasons. For saying he's my lawyer and then, you know, stabbing me in the back, a lot of other reasons. But, well, I don't really know that he has any, you know, tendencies like that. I did see him with the dress on, though. That was kind of not a good look. But, I don't know. Some people get down like that.
As soon as he hears this new information that you can get around the sex tourism laws by just not intending to go to fuck 14-year-olds, I can just hear this music in the background as his brain starts to chug along. Wait. He's really thinking about it. This changes everything, chat. Anyways. So that's the Ralph update. He, in his infinite wisdom, pushed back his travel date till after my stream. It was supposed to be before my stream, but unfortunately, he has moved that to this weekend. So I do not get to talk about his actual trip to Portugal until next week. Very, very unfortunate timing on that, but I will make do. I'll keep my eyes peeled on this situation as it continues to develop, chat. Anyways. I was invited to this, but it's at like 4 a.m. my time, and I've learned in the past to not get involved with this, because every time I get involved with PPP, it becomes a problem. And me even saying that is going to become a problem. People are going to be offended. But PPP is doing a thing called the Kino Casino with Andy Worski tonight. And you can, if you're interested in hearing about what Andy Worski has to say about Ralph, that will be a thing. PPP problems. pretty much that. It is a nightmare. Every time I get involved with PPP, it's just like, God, why'd I fucking bother? So, my three strikes with that have ran out. My patience has worn down. It's like every time I get involved with someone, it's like a fucking horrible disaster. So it's like, fuck, I'll stay in my little castle and be aloof and nihilistic, and I won't make friends because that's safe. That's nice and safe. I don't have to deal with things. Okay, that's the rough update. PPP stream is tonight if you are interested in that. Now, I only imagine at some point in recent history, there was a roundtable discussion where people got together and they thought like people in the government, and they thought like our biggest informant shill is now people are making fun of him, they're calling him gay. And it's making him look bad, and he's becoming less effective at spreading the message. How do we get this guy back on track so that people will stop calling him gay? So they stage this, like, okay, look, Nick, next time you're next to a woman, just gawk at her tits and say shit like, I'm gonna crush box. Say shit like that. Act like you are heterosexual. And pretend that, actually, you don't even have to pretend, really. Gay men still like booba, and a lot of women like booba. Boobs are aesthetic. People like them regardless of their orientation. Maybe he's just marveling that they're right next to him. That's the closest he's gotten, so he's impressed. So, and I also want to point out, I thought that was Brittany Vinti at first, but it's not. So. I don't know. I thought that Nick Fuentes was based in a red pill and he liked white women, but I guess not. They didn't get that part straight. They were like, fuck, can we find like a white woman to stand next to him? No? Okay. And then part two of the Catboy image rehabilitation program is that they had the January 6th commission subpoena him for testimony. So the announcement came from the Jan 6th committee. I didn't even know this was a thing. Apparently they actually set up a committee to investigate the boomer tour, the guided tour of the Capitol building on January 6th. It was so nice. Donald Trump said, hey, everybody, if you want to come see the Capitol building before I leave, come to D.C. And then they opened the doors and the boomers walked in and they stayed between the velvet ropes and they didn't fuck up any of the paintings or nice historical artifacts in the Capitol building. And they just walked around and looked at people. And then one of them got too rowdy and got shot in the fucking face. But, you know, you can't have a tour without breaking some eggs, I guess. Now they have a whole commission to figure out how did this guided tour happen? How did our security fail so phenomenally that this guided tour was permitted? Actually, you know what? It's probably investigating why that person got shot. What happened with our security where these nice boomers walking down the halls and looking at stuff were shot? How did this happen? Where was the security flaw here? Where our security guard had to murder this woman for walking around? So they subpoena, what was it? Subpoenas to Nick Fuentes and Patrick Casey, whose name I remember, but I don't remember anything about him. I just recognize the name Patrick Casey because it's like two first names and his last name is like a girl's first name. The committee is demanding records and testimony from the two witnesses who promoted unsupported claims about the 2020 election and were present on the Capitol grounds on January 6th. Nicholas J. Fuentes and Patrick Casey are leaders of the America First, or Graper, that's so cringe, the Graper movement. This is from a government Twitter account. They might put Graper in the fucking history books. There was once a little boy who was a Catholic homosexual, and he liked cat boys, and he went to the guided tour that President Trump held on the January 6th, and he was a groiper. And here's a picture of a frog with his hands folded on top of each other, and that's a groiper, and this is a very serious political image in our country's history. He almost overthrew the government that day when they went for that guided tour. Both individuals participated in events prior to January 6th promoting unsupported claims about the election, including the November 14th, 2020 Million MAGA March in D.C. and the December 12th, 2020 Stop the Steal rallies, also in D.C., where they called for the destruction of the Republican Party for failing to overturn the election. According to public reports, both Fuentes and Casey received $10,000 in Bitcoin from a French computer programmer. Funds the FBI has scrutinized to assess whether the funds from this donor were linked to the Capitol attack or otherwise used to fund illegal activity. So this is basically two guys from America First went to two different rallies and then got a big donation that they don't have any evidence to claim supported any criminal activity. But they just want to point it out there that some French guy, you know how those fucking French are, always beheading their politicians. Cringe. Over here, we just have guided tours. The French are fucking... They actually take their politicians and behead them when they're unhappy. Cringe. Can we check? Can we get an optics check on beheading politicians, chat? Do I want to read this? Pursuant to blah, 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 the select committee hereby transmit a subpoena that compels you to produce documents set forth on February 2nd to appear for February 9th. The select committee is investigating causes of January 6th attack and issues relating to peaceful transfer of power in order to evaluate lessons learned and recommend to the House and relevant committees corrective laws, politics. That's creepy, the way they word that. Inquiry includes examination. Who gives a fuck? Why are you saying this? It's like virtue signaling. It was an attack on American representative democracy. God forbid that my elected, you know, even my congressman's Matt Gaetz, Where would we be, chat, if we didn't have a peaceful transfer of power where people of color, indigenous peoples, Jewish, Israeli dual nationals, and sex traffickers like Matt Gaetz couldn't peacefully assemble in Congress? There would be a total breakdown of our society. They wouldn't be able to vote more laws into place, involve themselves in the military security of other countries like Afghanistan, send trillions of dollars of aid to other countries, accept bribes on behalf of multinational corporations like Disney to extend the copyright laws indefinitely. Where would we be, chat? We would be in ruins. I would be sitting on an empty dirt street in the middle of Nevada watching tumbleweed pass by me as society collapses. You overturned some shit and stopped the steal. Conservatives should be more feral. Published on Telegram on November 9th, you also spoke at another rally on Wisconsin State Capitol. In the same post, you promised groypers are going to stop this coup. And this is the time that I show you this clip.
I would like to live longer. I really would. But I don't fear death. Because if anything, if I get killed, I'll become a martyr in this world and in the next. If they come and kill me, you've just created 10,000 terrorists. Now, I don't want to impugn my followers and say, oh, they're all terrorists or something. But look, if they kill me, I become a martyr. And the name Nicholas J. Fuentes becomes a legend in the world as an American dissident gunned down by a liberal government, by our democracy, by the open society. And that marks the death of any kind of political outcome to this dilemma. Because if I can't even live in America, if they kill me, then there's no way. There is no way that this regime is going to produce any kind of change. So, now I mean, when I say 10,000 terrorists, I mean that very metaphorically. My followers are peaceful. My followers are nonviolent. I'm nonviolent. And, of course, we condemn terrorism. We're Christian. We don't believe in violence. But the point is this. You kill me, you make me a martyr. You kill me, you create a lot of problems for yourself in this world. In the next world, I go to heaven instantly. Kill me, and I go to heaven the second that I die. Skip purgatory. I'm passing through. Do not pass go. Do not collect 2,000 years in purgatory. Collect 200. I'm good. I go to heaven. Day one. Instantly. Beatific vision. I get to meet God. I would like to meet God later, though, you know? I want to meet God, but I got a lot of work here to do here. So, you know, please pray for me. Please say, you know, St. Michael's prayer for me. Please pray a rosary for my safety. I do legitimately fear for my life these days. That's why I'm saying this. You create a martyr out of me in this life and the next. I don't fear it. I don't want it, but I don't fear it. I fear God alone. We're all going to die one day. We are all going to die one day. Maybe not today. Maybe not tomorrow. Who knows? Maybe today. Maybe tomorrow. We are all going to die one day, and then we will stand before the author. I would like to live longer. I really
There is a message in this at the end. Tack nuke. I would die for you, Nick. Wow. Cringe. Cringe. I would die for my cat boy hero, Nick Fuentes. He's the most kawaii sequoia of all the cat boys on the internet. Imagine being tacked nuke. On November 14th, he rallied with America First / Groypers following the Million Mega March, urging your followers to storm every state capital until President Trump is inaugurated for 4 more years. Featured speakers like Alex Jones, who gives a fuck? Last paragraph. The Select Committee seeks documents regarding these and other matters that are within the scope of the Select Committee's inquiry. Your attorneys informed Select Committee staff that you declined the committee's request to testify and submit documents voluntarily. A copy of the rules governing the Select Committee's depositions and document production definitions and instructions are attached. Please contact staff for the select committee at this number to arrange for the production of documents. I've gotten subpoenas before, and someone remind me, in April, I have one to post, actually. I have another one, actually. I might be able to post it earlier, because one's for a year, has a order for a year, and the other one's for 6 months, and the one for 6 months came later, but I might get to post that one first. I'll have to set a note for myself, but like they very explicitly list what they need you to produce. It's like a very, like, we need everything related to this. Like, okay. Like, very obvious what they want. What is this? Like, the subpoena is like, we want every piece of information you have regarding, Alex Jones. Like, we need any messages that you sent out condoning like a violent usurping of the government? Is that what they're trying to say here? Are they even allowed to do that? You have to produce messages where you're incriminating yourself? I don't know. That's very strange. I would just tell them I ain't got shit for you. Everything that I say is public. Anything that you can find is public. There's no like secret Discord channel where I'm like communicating with people about violent plans. I have nothing to show you. And if you can prove otherwise, go for it. So it's like this entire document, the whole reason why it reads like so weird and preachy is because it's a virtue signal from the government. Like we're taking things seriously, guys. We're going to get to the bottom of this whole Groiper business. And we're going to like bring them up to death and stuff. And I was like, what are you looking for, bro? How about you enumerate the shit you actually expect me to give you? Complete waste of time. It's all posturing and shit. How gay. Very cringe, yeah. Okay. Let's make fun of Spectre again. So this is Spectre, in case you don't know. I like this drawing of him. It's really good, actually. Check it out. So Spectre is someone who has single-handedly brought more drama to Nick Fuentes, or not Nick Fuentes, Nick Riccata, the other Nick. Nick Riccata's channel than anyone else, because he's like, I really don't know what his specific role in the military is. I think that Spectre is U.S. Marine Corps Reserve. He may have been active duty at some point. I think his face is fucked up because of acne. It looks like he was burned by, like, an ISIS fire, like a Molotov cocktail or something. But I think it's, like, acne. Thank you for reminding me. Yeah. So he thinks he's, like, really hard-ass. But it's really, really hard for me to like hate someone on my site. I have terrible memory. Everyone listening to this podcast over a long enough time realizes that I have horrifically bad, like, short-term memory. Unless it's really important, unless it's a big deal, unless it's like seriously impactful or really, really funny, I forgive and forget almost immediately. Doesn't matter what it is, to the point where I'm almost like too forgiving of people. If they can manage to keep their retard shit spaced out enough, I will forgive basically everything, because I just don't have the capacity to hold a grudge against someone. But Spectre is someone who managed to earn a very rare position on my shit list because he insisted on saying we. He used the royal we anytime he referred to, like, his opinion and then the forum. Like, he would, like, become the forum's advocate in specific instances and make claims which were not true while saying we, as in him plus the forum. And I hate that. And I think, actually, I hated Brian Dunn, King of Pole, for the same exact reason. Like, stop. There is no we. It's you, motherfucker. You are the we. The French we. It's you and your opinion. And when you say we and you pretend that you know things you don't, it's like, whoa, buddy. I don't know who the fuck you think you are, but it ain't no we. Okay, like calm down. And he refused. He did this multiple times to the point where I still remember this. And I had to add like a special disclaimer to his profile saying that like everything I say is wrong and I do not represent the Kiwi Farms in any way. Like I had to make that very explicit, and people thought it was like a joke he had put there himself. But no, I actually forced that on him so that there would always, if someone screenshotted this dumb shit he was saying, nobody would have any false pretense that the little verified check mark next to his name meant that he spoke for anyone except himself. And I don't think he even does that half the time. Because he's like, he does digging. He thinks he's like a Spec Ops, you know, Marine Corps InfoSec, like digital surgeon extracting the delicate data from behind enemy lines and shit. And then he'll like extrapolate on that so far beyond what is reasonable and present it as substantiated fact when it's not. Like you have one document and it says one thing and it doesn't say anything else. So I don't know how the fuck you get from point A to point B. The only thing I can like sometimes he'll get useful stuff. Like he'll call the courthouse in Virginia. And it'll say, like, hello, is there an active charge against Ethan Ralph? And the court will say, yes, there is. And it's like, okay. And that's substantiated. But he'll take that, like, eight steps from what it is and say, like, oh, they, I can't remember the specifics because it's bullshit. And I didn't commit it to long-term memory. As I said, my memory is very bad. But he'll say, like, oh, they said this. And it's like, motherfucker, the call is right there. I listened to it myself. They did not mention that at all. Where are you getting this from? And it's super infuriating. But he really, really fucked up because at some point after this thread was made, someone went to me and said that he is deleting posts. I'm thinking, he shouldn't be. He really should not be deleting posts. So when someone deletes their fucking posts, I have to go into the database and run manual SQL queries to figure out what the fuck's been deleted. It's not an easy task. So when I'm tasked to look at what he's been deleting and I find a history of like 100+ posts that he's deleted over years, I'm not a happy camper. I don't remember that kind of shit. So I spend an hour undeleting his posts and checking, because some of them were deleted just because they're like double posts or whatever the fuck, like legitimate reasons you delete a post. But some of them were not. And the most egregious one that I found in that time was something that contained this line. I actually think it's on the page before. I went through. Yeah, these are all the posts that I dig up. And I found which ones are these. The ones in red are the ones that were specifically deleted because he wanted to undo them. And the most interesting one that I found was where he says this. Dean asked me to help him, and I agreed to do so. It's legal as long as I don't claim to be a lawyer or able to resent him in any capacity with the lawsuit. I drafted some of it, proofread it, and gave it to Dean to do as he saw fit. There was a brief time, and I don't know if he like still does this or what, but he did this thing where... Oh, there's no clip of it because it's like a boring thing. But he did like a fake. He literally like copied Nick Riccata. He did like a fake YouTube lawyer show because he's not a lawyer. He's like a U.S. Marine Corps reserve at best. And he someone points out that he lives in like a trailer with like disability income from the government. And that's what he supports himself with. And despite this, he does a show where he, like, pretends, he, like, interprets court documents without any legal understanding of what the fuck he's talking about whatsoever. And he tried to help this guy called, I think it's Dean Asaf. And he's being, it was like a frivolous bullshit lawsuit, I think, but he was being sued. And Spectre gave this man court documents to file as motions in a legal case. And in this post that he deleted, he specifically states that he was not he gave him shit. He drafted some of it, proofread it, and gave it to him to do as he saw fit with. He basically gave him legal advice and said, I can't legally to say that this is legal advice, but if I give you this motion, you can file it if you want to. Just saying. So it like it would be I would be in the wrong to try and interpret if he did under the letter of the law in Massachusetts give the guy legal advice. But I do know the outcome of this. The guy he gave the filing to, from what I understand, is being sued by someone in Texas. And the guy being sued is not in Texas, and he's never been to Texas. So, on its face, it should be a jurisdiction issue immediately. It should be, I'm being sued from the state I have no business in, therefore, there is jurisdictional issue. The court does not have jurisdiction over me in Texas. That's a very rudimentary type of filing, and it may not be advantageous to go for that as a dismissal all the time. For instance, when Russell Greer sued me in Utah, the court he sued me under probably is not the right court to sue me because I have no business in Utah. But my attorney didn't file a motion to dismiss under jurisdiction because they wanted to go for merits so that the case would be dismissed with prejudice, which it was. So that's a legal consideration that a lawyer will have. But because, from what I understand, because Spectre gave this guy a motion and he filed it, he now can no longer claim jurisdiction. He can no longer claim that. So I'll just read what this says. Update, it's official. The court ruled yesterday the guy Spectre was helping by writing his responses in the lawsuit filed against him accidentally waived jurisdiction, and his motion to dismiss was denied. One of his co-defendants, who had a real lawyer, was dismissed without prejudice from the lawsuit for lack of personal jurisdiction. In the legal thread for the case, Spectre posted that Asaf would be okay because the court would be lenient on a pro se idiot, and that Vicky, the other co-defendant, was officially safe from the suit when the plaintiff was unable to serve her within 90 days. She was served sometime after that and defaulted by not responding. So it says here from the dismissal, starting with Asaf, the federal rules of civil procedure say that the party can raise certain defenses by motion or in its first response of pleading, including the lack of personal jurisdiction. Though his first response to the FAC, the answer that he filed on August 4th, Asaf asserted several defenses, but none were that this court lacks jurisdiction over him. The court can now no longer consider that as a basis to dismiss the claim against Asaf. So he gave him a filing, and he said, trust me, bro, this makes sense. So the guy files it thinking, oh, okay, I guess it makes sense. It'll be safe for me to file it. What's the worst that can happen? Well, the worst that can happen is that now his easy get-out-of-jail-free card of this court has no jurisdiction over me is no longer possible, because he forfeited that, and any attorney in the country would know if he filed that motion without trying to plead jurisdiction, he would lose the ability to plead jurisdiction. They would all know that because they went to school for 3 fucking years to learn this shit, which Spectre did not. And Spectre gave this man bad legal advice, and it fucked with him, because now if this Asaf guy wants to continue to file, he's probably going to want to get an attorney. And the attorney is going to look at this and go, I can't believe you filed this bullshit. We could have gotten this dismissed in the first filing for jurisdiction. But now I'm going to have to undo the damage, and it's going to cost several thousand dollars. So that's why you don't take free advice. You get what you pay for when you pay for a lawyer. And if you pay nothing, you will get equally... I don't know. You'll get what you pay for, which is nothing. You'll get shit. What I'm trying to say very eloquently is that you'll get bad advice. Isn't it kind of silly that the court wouldn't say it themselves? All I can think about it is some child saying, no takey back suits. The courts can, at their discretion, file a motion sua sponte, which means on its own, right? Spontaneously. They can. But a judge is not on your team. He's supposed to be impartial. So why would a judge whose job is to be impartial, mediating these different parties to the letter of the law, say, actually, you should have filed this. It would have been in your favor. Like, that's not his job. He's not there to be your lawyer. He's not there to help you. He's there to look at what you file. And he, you know, a judge is also a lawyer. So he might be thinking, oh, well, this person doesn't want to plead jurisdiction. He wants to plead other things because he wants to get dismissal with prejudice, which is a valid tactic. But then once you do that, The judge says, well, now you can't file jurisdiction. You can't lose on your motion. Sorry, I hit my mic. You can't lose on your motion and then go back and try like a step one defense. That doesn't work. You know what I mean? That's why you get a lawyer. He'll walk you through your different options so you know exactly what to expect. Judges are supposed to interpret pro se filings leniently, which is when you're trying to assert a defense, if you fuck up a little bit, he's not going to go, oh, well, you missed your commas and periods here, so I'm not going to accept this. He'll try to figure out what the fuck you're trying to say, but he won't say, actually, you probably should be doing this instead. That's the difference. They'll interpret your filing as you want, but they won't develop legal tactics for you. Self-representation is cocked. There's a lawyerly expression about pro se litigants. It's like, I don't want to butcher it. If I think of it, I'll say what it is. But yeah, in general, it's like, yeah, have a lawyer. It helps. Legal taco job. Yeah, no shit. Now I'm knocking off Nick. I keep calling him Nick Fuentes. I feel like such an asshole. It's because he wore the dress. It fused them in my mind together. You really shouldn't have done that. That was in the world of optics, that was not a good look, as they say. Any man who represents himself has a fool for a client. That is correct. Thank you, Jennifer Hunt. That's what I was thinking of. Okay. I think I'm done. When did he wear a dress? Nick Ricardo wore like the hot pants, and I don't think he wore a dress. He wore like hot pants. I mean, he could have worn a dress. I don't watch everything he does. It's possible. Anything's possible on the internet. Okay, that's enough of bashing Spectre. You should stick to Discord, and you should stop saying we. By the way, I changed my layout. Can you tell, chat? I added Matt at the internet. And I even bought the domain. It was cheap. Maddie.live. It'll take you right to my website. Because I think a lot of people, when they type in madattheinternet.com, they forget the double T. It'll be like mad at he internet, and they'll get it wrong. So I got Maddie.live for a easy link to type in. And it includes the date. So now you know what today's date is. If you're watching live, you've figured it out. You know, you don't have to look at your calendar while you're watching my stream. You can just look down and think, that's what today is. I can't wait to forget to update that every week. That'll be awesome. Maddie.f. Dude, there's some tranny who owns fucking kiwifarms.f. So I can't get that unstoppable domain. If that person's not a tranny, give me my domain name. You cocksucker. You motherfucker. Ethereum is worth nothing now. It's all crashed. It went down the drain. So you can give it to me for free. That's why Unstoppable Domains is better, because they like contacted people who have websites and are like, hey, do you want this? And it's like, oh, sure. I'll support your technology because you reached out to me. Instead of letting it be a fucking free-for-all and letting trannies buy your domain name immediately. And a real quick update. I just want to get to this first. Someone asked me to talk about H3, and I will briefly talk about H3 only for one reason, okay? So H3 tried to start a fight with Joe Rogan. Joe Rogan smartly ignored the shrill, shrieking Israeli, and nothing happened with that. He then picked a fight with Jordan Peterson, who did reply, and then he deleted all his podcasts with Jordan Peterson on them, like retroactively deleted his archives. And Jordan Peterson and him have had like a Twitter back and forth, but who cares? I want to show you this clip of Rusty Cage. Rusty Cage remixed this song for H3H3. And once it buffers for a second, I'm going to play it for everyone so we can enjoy it together. A couple seconds of this.
Bro,
By the way, did you know that this was H3's wife? I moved on from playing white girls fuck dogs every episode to this. Okay. That's the H3 update. I hope that, God, who requested this? Burning Fanatic? I hope Burning Fanatic has been satisfied by my coverage of H3. I've summed this up in a way. There's like, I also find it funny. There's like a Reddit dedicated to shitting on Trisha Paytas. And like, apparently, how petty is this, right? Fucking H3 reads that shit. And I know motherfuckers listening to this, you're internet famous and you read your threads. It's cringe. It's cringe. You know, I know people talk shit about me. I don't read any of it. I don't read a single fucking thing. There's like websites dedicated to me that have huge, huge posts and shit. And I don't read any of it because I don't give a fuck. And I know you're listening to this waiting for your name drop. And it's cringe. Perfect. A fat woman update. Okay, we got to get to this. We gotta get to this. So here's the fat woman update. Ready? Noel's like, no. That's a skill. You gotta train that shit. You gotta turn off your brain. People saying shit. Click. Brain off. Brain smooth. No wrinkles. No tinking. Just talking about Chantal. That's all that matters, chat. Okay. Let me think how to describe it. My brain is off. I literally put my hands to my head and made a clicking noise and turned my head like I was turning a knob on my brain. And now I can't think at all. Something has happened. My mind is broken. So Chantal has had a back and forth with this guy named Nader. N-A-D-E-R, Nader. Actually, it's literally pronounced like Nader. It's like the ugliest name ever. I thought it was like a fancy name like Nadia, but it's not. It's just Nader. Like, wasn't he like a presidential candidate? Nader? Anyways. So Nader is like Egyptian. He doesn't speak English. I've been told that he speaks French, but I don't think that's true. I just think he doesn't speak anything. I think he's like a deaf mute and he can barely communicate with anyone. And they've been breaking up and getting back together for literally weeks now, since like before December. And there has been a constant reoccurring meme in, what is it? Why she goes back to him. She will have a big fit. She'll talk shit about him. And they will go back and forth for watching each other. Have I had a stroke? I think I did have a stroke, actually. I'm sorry. They will do live streams covering each other, watching each other live and responding to each other as they both live stream from the other side. And it's like the most juvenile shit possible. But then there is a moment where she will say, I need my CPAP machine. I see my CPAP machine and I'm going over to his house to get my CPAP machine. And then she paints her nails. She gets all dressed up, all fancy, puts on her makeup, draws on her hairline because her hair is very thin. So she takes like a thing, literally paints black onto her scalp so that she can look like she has hair. and then goes to his house, all glammed up, and knocks on the door and is like, I need my CPAP machine. And then she's gone for a day. And she's definitely at his place, and they've made up, and she'll come back online in a couple days and is like, guys, I really don't want to talk about Nader. We made up again. Yes, I know. I'm sorry to my Beezers. We made up again, and I think I should keep this offline going forward. And then in like 3 days, she's like, this abusive asshole motherfucker. I do so much shit for him. I get on my knees and I kiss his feet, and he's over there eating my tenderloin with this new bitch named Dee Dee. Just like, oh, it happens over and over again. And she always says, he has my CPAP machine. I got to go back and get my CPAP machine. So she does, and then they get back together again. Like clockwork. Just goes back to this fucking guy to get her CPAP machine. But then this week, it happened again, and she's at his house, and this time it's like more angry than usual. It's been building up. Like it was a, you know, like comments after the fact at first, and then it was just like she was angry venting, driving from his place back home, and then it was actually like driving to his house and like, I'm gonna go get my CPAP machine. I'm turning off my stream now. And then this time she's banging on the fucking door and is like, give me my CPAP machine. I want my CPAP machine. And during their argument, because she pays for his rent and his like cell phone and iPad and shit, she turns off his cell phone. And like she edits his videos and posts his videos on YouTube because he's like a wannabe like YouTube celebrity chef. So he's like, she's posting videos for him. She deletes his stream, like midstream, while they're talking to each other. And then she's like, give me my CPAP machine. And he's like, give me my video. Give me my video. You delete my video. You took from me. You took from me, bitch. You took from me. I give you breathe machine. You give me my video. And they're just yelling at each other. And they're both streaming it. And it's just like fucking nuts. She gets back in her car and she's like crying. She's driving away saying, I just wanted my CPAP machine. So I, as a hero, I super chatted her and I said, Chantal, you go back there and you call the police and you get Pappy. And she literally turns the car around and goes back to the house. And the police show up, and they go into the crack shack where Nader lives, and this happens. It's muted, but it gets unmuted.
Guys, stay with me 1 minute. So I put you off the camera. Thank you. I mute you guys.
So you still on the computer? You are on YouTube, on Facebook, on something?
Sorry?
You are on Facebook, right?
I was on YouTube.
It was recording
a
video. Okay.
Yeah.
What are you cooking? Beef
and French fries.
What are you cooking, he says. Police in Canada are like a different breed. Number one, I love this guy's accent. He's like, what are you cooking, eh? Like, just fucking crazy levels of Canadian. They're in Quebec, by the way. They're in like a really small, like, village, town, whatever the fuck, in Quebec. So all the cops that are like bilingual, they speak French and shit. But they're really friendly. They're just like, yeah, we're getting her breathe machine, eh?
We are here because I hear we have an argument with your ex or something like that.
She was not my ex, it was my friend.
Your friends?
Yes.
Okay, so no relationship with
she them? Says that he says that there's no relationship. That's a lie. Cop is confused because it's like, obviously, you guys are having like a domestic. But that's important because he bitches out in a second. And what he says by saying that they didn't have a relationship will hinder his arguments for getting what he wants later on.
Okay. She's here because she wants his breathe machine or something like that.
She got one here. Yes. And she actually, she asked to come get it and I don't tell her, no, you cannot get it. But before she come get it, she go on my live stream in my videos and delete all of them. And this is not legal act she did it.
Okay.
You go on my YouTube and delete my stuff. Mm-hmm. This is not legal.
Okay. I think you can go to civil court.
Okay. So first off, he's like, we need her breathe machine. And he's like, what about my video? She deleted my video. I want my video. And he's just like, I don't know about that, eh? But you can go to civil court if you want, eh? And he just continues to like rant at this cop about his fucking YouTube channel. Mm-hmm.
This is not legal.
Okay. I think you can go to civil court for that. Okay, it's not criminal.
And also, if you can check,
I'm just here.
You can check
to
the name.
Sure.
We can ask her. She always all her live stream here, my friend. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All day, all 7 months, talking shit about me.
So he thinks that the stream is muted, and he's bitching out to these cops hard. Before he was like, "I do not call police. Do not call police. Get off my porch." And now he's like, "Oh, she deleted my YouTube video, and she's been talking shit about me on the internet all day." And he's like unloading on this cop like he's a therapist. And I have a theory for this that I will explain in a second.
Both in me, was her roommate, with everybody. I can leave. Tell her, shut up, what you need? Say me what you need. She keep talking and talking and talking and talking.
Okay.
For something happen and something lies, she don't even care.
Okay.
But to come to my YouTube and delete my stuff, this is my work. This is how I make money.
Yeah.
To delete my videos, that's not legal act. And I never tell her.
Why do you call faire money à l'intérieur sans vidéo? Merci. So, okay.
And I never tell her you're not allowed to take your stuff. You can watch his own live stream.
He's so lying about that too. He said repeatedly, if you want your CPAP machine, just come get it. And then she's at the door saying, give me my CPAP machine. He's like, I never say that she could not get it. I never say. Like, he's blocking her outside the house and refusing to let her get her fucking medical device. It's like, just give it to her. Holy shit, what a retard. And by the way, everyone calls him Stabby Nad because... He went to jail for stabbing an ex in a domestic that he had years ago, and he's still on probation for it. And I'm pretty sure if Canadian probation is anything like American probation, he's going to have to explain. He has to tell his parole officer any encounters that he has with the police, right? Isn't that how it works in the U.S.? So he's going to have to tell his parole officer, yeah, I refuse to let my ex-girlfriend come inside to get her medical equipment. And the police showed up because neither one of them, by the way, they were both live streaming at the time the police showed up. So nobody knows who called the police. It could have been like a Karen. It could have been Peetz. It could have been anyone. So nobody knows who did it, but the police do show up, and now he's in trouble for it. And he's mad that she called the police because I assume he knows that she knows that if the police show up, he's going to have to report that to his PO.
What they say and what they say. But now, I need a personal order against this person. This person is crazy.
Okay. I'm just really here to have his breath machine, and I'm going to go.
The breath machine.
Yes, but I need a personal order against him because this doesn't happen.
Okay. What?
A personal order against her.
She's
not allowed to contact me anymore.
Yes, but for that, you have to go to the bus.
But can you...
So this is also a great part. Now he's asking for a restraining order against Chantal, a 5'4", 350-pound woman who literally cannot stand to do dishes because she is too fat to stand on her feet long enough to clean plates. And she's like too... unable, like she's not physically able to like load and unload the dishwashing machine, and yet he feels endangered by this woman enough to ask two cops from the Quebec Police Department to get a restraining order against him. And they basically say, we can't do that, we can break up the dispute right here, but you have to go to court to get a restraining order. And he just doesn't get it, and he just keeps talking over them because he's so unhappy with that answer. He's like, they're giving him advice on what to do. You want a restraining order, go to the court. And he's like yelling over them about his fucking YouTube videos.
You're not allowed to come even my
stairs. I can say to her, you don't want her
here. I want her here, yes.
Okay. But for that, you have to go to the police station, take a report about that. Okay, I don't think tonight we're going to... Come solve all the problems.
I didn't make my accent southern.
So I think you have something you want to do on Facebook,
yes,
and YouTube.
Yeah.
So I think you want to do your cash now, yeah, right now.
Yeah.
So
she made me miss like $500 today.
Yes.
I work all day for nothing.
So I'm just here to make sure she's gonna go. So if I have to breed machine, she's gonna go. Okay, so can you go?
he still calls it, like, I thought it was like the once off thing, but he keeps, like, because she had to explain to him what a CPAP was, because he's like a cop, so he's like not fat. I guess in other countries, your cops aren't morbidly obese and unable to move or take care of themselves or wipe their own ass. In the U.S., they are fat. They are fat fucks who can't wipe their own ass. So they all know what a CPAP machine is. But in Canada, this guy probably works out. So he's like, oh, okay, you can't breathe, eh? You need equipment. You need a breathe machine to breathe, eh? Okay, we'll go get it for you. So he has to, like, relay this information in language he understands.
Take the breathe machine, bring me, and...
The bees machine. I'm trying to do French.
I never tell her I'm not going to take it. This is the problem. I can't go with you now. And I said, I never tell her you cannot take it. That means now. She will delete my videos, my stuff, and come to bug me.
Yes.
I need my stuff now, but you know, I delete your stuff. It's not fair. It's not even logically.
It's not fair. He's telling the police it's not fair that she deletes my videos and then gets to have her breathe machine. If she wants to breathe, she should give me my video back. It's not fair. He starts talking French with the Didi, the other woman. And by the way, I've not heard that much French in my life, but it's very, very obvious the difference between Quebec French and, like, European French. And I understand why European French people get, like, so salty about Quebec French. Because it sounds like, like, if you hear people speaking Dutch, it sounds like German, but, like, in a really strong English accent. And when you hear Quebec people talking French, it sounds like French in, like, a really, like, American accent. So I definitely hear why French people get pissed off listening to the Quebec accent.
Are you lying? Are you lying? You need to
breathe? Oui, oui. Et bon,
okay. Le ce soir, ça va être bon pour vous, ce qu'il va préparer?
Hein?
Ça va être bon, ce
qu'il va préparer? Non, ça va être bon, oui, des frites, c'est ça, avec du bœuf, je sais pas exactement, il va voir ce qu'il y a dans son frigidaire, puis il va faire quelque chose.
Ok, il prépare rien comme d'avance,
il fait non, juste... Non, il fait tout frais. Ok. Ouais. C'est un chef, là, il fait 25 ans qu'il est un chef.
Okay. Ouais. Ukrainian is way, like, softer than Russian. Like, Ukrainian is a much more, like pleasant sounding language, I think. I don't know. I guess oh god, I'm probably gonna get shot for that. Fucking Slavs hate each other more than anyone else. Ukrainian, it can sound very, very nice though. Oops, sorry, I muted myself, but there's no audio. Where is he at? Come back with the breathe machine, man. Oh, that's the bag. So he gives the bag of goodies.
Thank you. Do you have any piece of party with you?
Yeah, I have
some
My friend who is with me since 2 days now. Okay. She has her vacation time and she's been there with me and she knows everything. This is crazy. Insane.
Okay. Yeah.
613 415
3806. 38? Oh. He gives out a phone number. Hopefully I didn't play all that on stream, but he gives out a phone number thinking that it's muted. And I think people tried to call it, but it was out of service. So he gave the cops the phone number that Chantal had turned off, so they can't call
him. you have to go to the police station, okay? Explain to a police officer what's going on.
But in this report, explain what is going
on tonight. Okay, okay, not on your whole own life, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Just tonight. Okay. What's happened tonight?
Okay.
Okay. And from you, you have to press charge, like for a restraining order.
I don't need to press charge. I just need to don't be here. I like peace.
Yes,
peace.
But
if you can tell it, that's verbally, just peace. Do not lie.
Only a judge can give you a restraining order. Okay. So
this whole thing. This is the part where the cop is explaining to him, "I am a police officer. There is a domestic disturbance here. I am here to sort this shit out so that the people next door to you can go back to bed because they're annoyed by the crazy bitch outside your house honking her fucking horn and driving up and down the street over and over again and knocking on your porch and screaming about a breathe machine. They're fucking irritated. They want to go to bed. And all I'm trying to do is sort this shit out." And he's like, "I want restraining order. I want my video. She's a bitch. She's talking shit about me." And he's like, "I don't care. If you want to go to the police station and file a report because you're afraid of," he literally says, "if you're afraid of her, you can go to the police station and file a report for a restraining order. If your shit was stolen, you have to go to civil court to straighten that out. All I know is I'm getting fucking pappy and I'm getting the hell out of here and you can shut the fuck up." And he doesn't get it. He's so irate. He's just talking over her the entire, or over him the entire time.
Okay. So we're gonna do the report tonight, but on your side, go to the police station, explain
what you live. So I know she's sick. I don't like to be shot and somebody's sick. Mm-hmm. In the same time, I need you away from me.
Yeah, I understand that, okay? But I cannot just give some condition to someone, okay? A judge can give some condition, okay? So the restraining order, it's only a judge. That must be approved by a judge, okay? So this report, it's only for what's happened tonight,
okay? Thank you.
So thanks, and have a good night.
You too.
Good,
thank you.
What's your YouTube channel name?
My name?
The YouTube channel.
Nader,
show me
my
name. You in
there?
Yeah.
Yeah, go check it out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And check it out. Go investigate that shit.
Wow. You and me, everything
is me. So, at this point, he talks, the camera comes back on, moves around, and he starts talking, right? And I like this, watch.
She don't ask for it.
You can take your mask off, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, I just noticed that.
So police came. They actually very respectful people. Here. Oh. 1 minute, guys.
She's asking for a power cord in the mask.
Now Didi remembers to fucking mute it. She doesn't mute it for that. But what happens here is that the police come back. Nadir, in his infinite pettiness, did not give Chantal the electrical cord for the AC adapter to the CPAP machine, and he did not give her her breath mask that you attach to it, so that you affix to your face. A CPAP machine just creates pressure, and you need to actually attach it to your face holes to make it work, and you need electricity for it to work at all. So Nadir gave him only the actual machine, and not any of the parts that is needed to make it work. And he obviously, considering that he has had this machine in his house for weeks, and she sleeps over there, understands that the mask and the electrical cord are an important part of how this machine operates. It's basic sense. Like, anyone knows this. So he is being extra super petty this entire time. And you can really tell in how he talks after this, like that's filet mignon on the table that Chantal bought that he's cooking for Didi. And you can tell just by the way he's like beating the fuck out of this meat, the way he talks, like his body, he is pissed. And it became really obvious because this is like the most you see of Nadir ever is this guy, like his streams right now. And you can really tell he is like a power and control freak. And the fact that a cop came over and made him relinquish Pappy unto them actually literally pisses him off because he had power and control over her by having this machine and the cops forced him to give it up. So he like spited her by only giving half of it.
Did that bother you guys this noise?
I gotta move this.
He's tenderizing it. He's like an actual trained chef, and for whatever reason, he's taken filet mignon and he's like tenderizing it with the back of a steak knife or a chef's knife. I don't know why he's doing that.
Anyway, she got her broken machine, and I got the number for the report I made, and it's gonna be restraining order.
He's a line cook? I thought he was an actual chef.
So, you don't like to...
Does anyone get the feeling that he's taking out a little bit of aggression on this poor meat, which is already tender and does not need to be tenderized?
Do your life by yourself. So you have to do it, girl.
Is it too loud for you guys? I can mute it if you want.
Ask them.
Uh-huh. So just...
There's a part I'm waiting for. I'll skip ahead a bit. He explained something. He says that he got a restraining order against him, or against her, which is a lie because we heard the conversation and the cop said that if you want a restraining order, you have to go to the police, like the actual station, to file a report. So he lies, and then he realizes that he looks like a super bitch now that like he's embarrassed that he had that conversation broadcasted. So he starts singing in Arabic. To show everyone like how not bothered he is. And I really have to say, Arabic is the ugliest fucking language. I've heard a lot of languages in my life. I've been all over, right, Mr. Worldwide. Arabic is fucking ugly. It is an ugly language. It sounds terrible. It never sounds like actual human talk. Like Congolese clicking noise sounds more like a coherent language than fucking Arabic. It's so awful. Wrong. Throat gurgles, bass, orc speak. Like even Turkish sounds better than Arabic. Turkish is like a real language. It's influenced by like Europeans and shit. The Kangs and shit. Vietnamese is nice sounding. Yeah, Asian languages are pretty harsh. But Arabic, I don't know. I'd still say like Arabic is way worse. Asianic languages are only weird because you like look at their alphabet and you think like, how the fuck is this a language? How do people read this shit? And I guess Arabic is the same way. You look at the scribbles, the fucking little dashes and swirls and things, and you're like, how is this a language? How do you read this? Why is it backwards? Why do you sing like that? Why do you sing by talking? Why don't you have instruments? Why did your prophet prohibit instruments in your songs? Why are things like this? English, best language. Objectively true. That's why more people speak it than any other language. And Chinese cheats. They're second place in languages only because they keep reproducing. English speakers forgot how to reproduce. Also, this clip is very funny, by the way. When they were having their back and forth arguments on live streams, this clip is obnoxious because you keep hearing like the feedback loop of his stream playing to her stream and so on. But he says something really funny. They're arguing about Peetz. He really hates Peetz because she lives with her like ex-boyfriend Peetz. And I've already explained that Peetz is like a castrate who doesn't have like sexual desires. He only feels it like bubbling rage all the time. So for Nader to be like jealous of Peetz is like the weirdest shit because he's so non-threatening. But it's a recurring theme, and this is pretty funny.
Where? His ass getting bigger. His ass getting bigger than you. He take hormone, I guess. Did you start to use the medication?
He's saying that Peetz's tits are big and ask him if he's on HRT. Let me explain this because he doesn't speak English worth a shit.
Did you take the part off or still there? Take it off or still there?
He asked if he chopped off his dick.
You take the hormone, I guess?
What?
Huh?
Ah, you take it off? I'm still there.
That is bad.
I'm bad. Don't fuck around with me. I'm bad. I hit the spot.
Trans shamer.
Trans shamer.
Anyway, Peetz is not even trans.
What? Isn't it what? I see you. I see you in the video with the dress. You look cute, buddy. You was really cute. I have somebody here was hidden on you. But he wait until you finish the work, the job. Until you get rid of the part you don't like.
He's telling Peetz that he looked cute in a dress, but he won't fuck him until he gets rid of the part that he doesn't like. So, what the fuck?
I know, thank you. I appreciate that. You dress for people to tell you, oh, you're so sweet, you're so cute, you look beautiful. Yeah, you're sexy, bald guy.
Sorry, Karen.
Go shower before you dress.
I don't think I ever showed this on stream. Many of you will already know that this is a thing. I did not feature this. I did not put this on the front page of the forum. I did not talk about this in my live stream because Peetz was just starting to hatch. And I know if I turned the Eye of Sauron on Peetz, he would immediately burn up in the gaze. But now I'm forced to break the news to everyone that on New Year's, he has a female alter ego, like a superhero. Like he likes the X-Men, right? So his female alter ego is Ramona. And he did a full stream dressed up as Ramona. They went and picked out dresses so that he could be Ramona for this stream. And he says he's not trans. He says that Ramona is just his alter ego. And it's just something that is fun. It's fun to him. It's not a serious thing. It's just a little bit of fun. Girls just like to have fun, right? So Nader, when Nader is saying that he's cute and he's a sexy bald man and he would fuck him if he gets the bad part removed, this is what's happening. Okay, sorry to break it to you so soon. I was gonna keep this secret for later, and I hope that Peetz. Don't let my cyberbullying turn you away, okay? If this is what will make you happy, like you can get your own Nadir. In the Arab world, if you transition, this is true. This is completely true. This is not bullshit. In Iran, the country you would expect to be the most homophobic in the world, in Iran, if you get gender sexual reassignment surgery, you can legally change your gender to female from male in Iran. So even in Iran, trans rights are rights. The Ayatollah of Iran says trans rights are rights and trans women are women. So saith Ayatollah of Iran. And you can pick up your own Nadir once you get the bad bits removed. Okay. So don't let me cyberbully you out of this. I was in his chat. I was watching the New Year's live stream live. I was in his chat, a couple hundred people there, and he was so happy. I've never seen this man happy in my entire life. Every time I see him, he is so sad, so unenthusiastic, listlessly drifting through the years of his middle ages, as if his brain and soul have turned off. His brain turned off, soul left his body. And then he puts on the dress and he's Ramona and he's genuinely happy for the first time ever. And he's taking song suggestions and he's like singing and stuff and he's letting loose. He's letting the girls out. He's being happy. And then I said, because someone said play Doja Cat. So he picked up like a random song from Doja Cat and it was some trashy fucking rap song. It was garbage. I said, no, play Moo. Play Bitch I'm a Cow by Doja Cat. That's her good song. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Doja Cat Cow. Here we go. Say the words.
Bitch, I'm a cow. I'm not a cat. I don't say meow. Bitch, I'm a cow.
bitch, I'm a cow. So I'm like, play this song. This is the good song. This is the only good song from Doja Cat. The rest is like trashy hip-hop shit. Bitch, I'm a cow is a classic. Moo, moo, moo. That shit, that hits hard. That hits hard. That strikes deep in the soul. And I say, play Cow by Doja Cat. And he sees my message. And I can tell he sees my message because the mood changes immediately. He goes from happy, not a care in the world, to like staring at his screen. And it's like I did something I call the crazy walk. If I will talk to myself. I'll catch myself doing this, but I'll talk to myself. I'll walk up and down the hallway and I'll talk to myself and I'll have like a one-sided conversation. If I'm thinking over something that's complicated and I just have to get my thoughts out, it helps to talk, to orate it. But if for whatever reason in my schizo crazy walking, I acknowledge that I'm talking to myself, it's over. I can't do it anymore. I'm suddenly very self-conscious about it and I just shut up and it stops immediately. It's very weird. If I break the fourth wall, I can't carry it anymore. And when Peetz realized other people that he knows, me of all people, saw him as Ramona, the crazy walk stopped, and it fucked with his perspective. He was no longer gender euphoric, so I completely dropped out of the chat, and I let him carry on. And after a couple minutes, he was. 10-15 minutes or so, he was back to where he was. But I realized I ruined it for him by acknowledging it. He didn't care. For whatever reason, he didn't care about knowing that the forum would make fun of him, but he cared that I was present in his chat in that moment. That ruined it for him. Josh Kerr's truning. You bring misery. Show the Peetz rage. I got it. Where is it? Oh, I have it somewhere. Give me a second. It's on my Firefox. He got mad. He's been trying to do a let's play of Mass Effect, and here, I think this is it. He got really pissed off because he recorded and he didn't set up his recorder correctly. And he got super pissed off. Let's see if I have the clip. It's in this thread is fucking short. I will go page by page until I find this shit. Okay. I guess I'm just gonna scroll manually. Oh, here, let me computer.
Yeah, me too.
I'll replay that.
I fucking hate computers.
Look at her face.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, it's great. This is the whole thing. Oh, please load. Don't you fucking do this to me, computer.
Man, playing a little bit of Mass Effect seemed like.
Give it a second. Give it a second to boofer chat. You know how my. I'm supposedly soon getting new networking. It's going to be expensive too, but hopefully my boofering issue will be resolved after this.
Man, playing a little bit of Mass Effect seemed like a great idea. It won't fucking load.
The same problem?
Oh. I'm so sad. I can't believe it's going to boofer on me, chap. Here. Oh, well. I think you get the gist of it. It's just,
No, like, the game itself literally won't fucking come up.
Apple, I think.
It keeps freezing on me.
Yeah, that's so frustrating.
I really hate how she chews with her mouth open. I don't know why she chews with her mouth open, chat, but she does chew with her mouth open. Everything she puts into her mouth, she has to do and chew with lips completely unadjoined, jaw just flapping, chewing. And It drives me crazy, and I can't. It makes it hard for me to even enjoy these good moments because of it.
Sam. Sam wants some, but he can't.
Play the per capita Peetz rage. Okay, I might be able to find that too. That's like I think he deleted that even. Yeah, he definitely deleted that. He had like a proper tard rage because he was doing a live chat, and someone he was arguing about like politics, and someone misunderstood what he meant when he said per capita, and he had like a proper fucking tard rage about per capita and the meaning of per capita. And was just yelling like a lunatic about per capita. There's no fucking way this video is gonna live. This is gonna be like an hour long. How's it gonna load? Let's see if we can scan chat. Dare I push it to the limits?
Uyghur, yes.
Uyghur. It always sounds like Uyghur to me. We gotta free.
Oh, I know a lot of them.
We gotta free the Uyghurs in China. They're being oppressed.
You feel like it so far?
Xi Jinping says to pull up your pants and stop acting black, and the Uyghurs are oppressed by this. I might be able to.
Oh, stupidly.
Yeah, that's it.
Stupidly uneducated position. Right, but like, no, that's not how statistics work. Reject reacts. It's not how statistics work. Like, whether you have 350 million people or 30 million people, per capita is referring to, like, gah! Gah!
I'm going to pass it a little bit. So we're at 1940 now. Let's go back just a little bit. I might have fucked it. I might have gone too far, chat.
Idiot! Like, honestly, it's... That is so stupid, I don't even know where to begin with explaining why you're an idiot. It's just... absolutely... mind-bafflingly stupid a comment! You do not understand what per capita means, you jackass. Like, all politics is like, political politics aside, all that. Learn what fucking words mean, guy. Learn what words mean, you fucking moron. Like, that's all I can say is, like, ugh. Like, it's just a so stupidly uneducated position.
What I really love about this whole thing, he just repeats himself over and over again. Such a fucking idiot. How do you not know anything? Like, politics aside, just like, how do you not know what this means? It's like a combination of things. Number one, I think that Peetz is genuinely like an angry person in general. I think that he has a lot of like harbored resentment towards like women and how he's been treated and his frustrations with relationships. But he can't say that. Like, the difference between, like, a male feminist and, like, an incel is pragmatic, like, it's not very different. It's just that a male feminist has these blinders on where it's not women's fault. An incel will explicitly blame women and say that it's women's fault. They should be having sex with me. I'm a nice guy. They only fuck these chads that don't treat them right when I'm a real gentleman. And they're whores because they don't fuck me. That's the incel perspective. The male feminist is angry at women in exactly the same way, but they can't say those things because they it's against their like their political autism. So it like just builds in this depression, and then they get mad at stupid shit on Twitter. And when you see like some bald soy-filled, like, balloon animal, like Peetz, who by the way is Canadian and should not be getting a rage boner over fucking American politics all the time, because he's not even American. It doesn't fucking matter. Who gives a shit? Like, how do you get mad over the Uyghurs and Putin and Ukraine and Hungary and Poland and the UK and JK Rowling? How do you care when you're a Canadian? Like, how do you give a fuck? So he just sits there and he gets mad and he funnels all this anger that he has towards, you know, political things. And then he reads a Reddit post, and it's a really great Reddit post. He agrees with it completely, and it's great because he agrees with it. And then he's talking to people who disagree with him, and they challenge him in any way, shape, or form. And it doesn't jive with the Reddit post that he read that was super great because he agreed with it. So he's angry. He doesn't know how to express himself because the thoughts that he has aren't his own, and he can't articulate them in a way that's responsive or flexible to the situation at all. And he can't just start screaming about how he thinks women are cunts and they need to be buried in a mass grave, because that's against his politics that he has to profess at all times. So he sits there, and for 3 minutes, he inarticulately complains about someone not understanding what per capita means, or maybe not even not understanding it, but just not hearing, oh, he said per capita. Like, you know, it could have just been a mistake, but he's like impotently angry about this. And that's just like the tip of the iceberg. You see a little bit of that boiling inner rage peeking out over the top in like a weird, obtuse, autistic way. And it's like, I really think that this guy is filled with a genuine, passionate hatred of every facet of his life. And I don't know. That's just the vibe I get. Maybe I'm reading too much into it, Chad. You think I'm close? Female energy, Canada is dead inside, the tip of the autism, tip of the iceberg. He's just always on the lookout for a reason to chump because it's simmering under the surface. Exactly, that's how I feel. Troons are incels, that's correct. Milk, that sounds like a familiar name. Isn't there like a turf channel called Milk? I'm pretty sure. Maybe I'm wrong. As a Canadian, I actually had a friend in her friendship over me for not hating Trump. Probably drowns himself in left-wing U.S. media constantly. Probably. If you say wrong capita in Canada, you get 1 year jail. Big soy energy. Yeah. This is just what I get. It's just that song by the Mighty Mighty Bass Tones or Bass Tones. That's just the impression that I get. Take your meds. No. You can't make me. Okay, that's enough with Peetz and Chantal for today. There's one more thing. I actually have quite a bit to play from this. Have I been streaming for like 2 hours? Oh my god. Okay, we're going to go over 2 hours today because I have audio that I want to play. It's going to be about 10 minutes long. And that will be the end of it. After that, I'm just going to play a new song that came out from Hardman Working Hard. There's a song that I want to play from MC Jarbo as well, but that'll have to wait because I like this one. This one's more appropriate for the stream. But last year, there was a guy named Patrick Tomlinson, who is a sci-fi author. Apparently, he's pretty successful as a sci-fi author, or once was. And now, he's like a Peetz. He's on Twitter. If you go to his Twitter account, it's just constant bitching about politics. And worse than that, like, even worse than, like, bitching about politics, like, in a shoe on head or vouch way, he's, like, staunchly pro-Democrat. He's one of those people who are, like, Democrat good, Republicans bad. Like the most low IQ possible political take to have, where the political party spectrum in the US has a good and a bad side. The kind of people who should not be voting because they obviously are fucking retarded, and who they're the kind of person who got the country in this position to begin with. Just dumb. Dumb, dumb guy. And I don't know his full history. I'm sure it could be worth a person stream in the future, but I don't know enough about him, so I'd have to get like a layout. But he's a big locale in a different community. He has his own thread. It's quite popular, but it is especially popular with the Opie and Anthony crowd. And at some point, we talked about maybe opening an Opie and Anthony board because their Reddit got shut down. And I was actually warned not to let the Opie and Anthony people on the site because they are so big into like hardcore A-logging the Opie and Anthony people that it would not be a good fit for the site. So I took that advice and I never opened an Opie and Anthony board, but I think I helped them in some way host their site because I think they use 1776 at least briefly because I got Cloudflare complaints about their site at some point. So they're sort of like little Kiwi Farms just for Opie and Anthony stuff. I don't know all that much about that universe. I was never into Opie and Anthony. The only person I knew who was into Opie and Anthony was Katsu Kitty, who was a... who is the reason why, to this day, people accuse the Kiwi Farms of having tranny moderators, because Katsu was gay and lost his virginity to a tranny and then became a tranny and added she, her pronouns to his admin profile and then somehow just disappeared one day and completely vanished off the face of the planet. So Katsu is the only person I knew who listened to Opie and Anthony because he was like a closet log house conservative. Very interesting person. I kind of miss him because he was nice. And it was around in the early days of the forum. He was an admin I did not appoint, I think. I think he's a staff who was a staff before I was the owner of the site. Anyways, Opie and Anthony. Patrick Tomlinson was a guest on Opie and Anthony. I don't know how he came about, but he ends up getting trolled the fuck out by all these different people. And at some point, he files a lawsuit against 60 John Does, against Opie and Anthony, and don't say 41%. There's hope for him. There's hope for him to de-trans and become a man. Don't tell me he's joined the 41% chat. But he sued 60 people, and most of them were on Opie and Anthony. I think one of them was, I think he was also trying to find out who the author of the Kiwi Farms thread was. But he sent a subpoena to Cloudflare to get my information about who owns the Kiwi Farms. And I immediately lawyer up. I think I went with... Legal Eagle. It was like someone from that Nick Ricada suggested, who was like a YouTube attorney or some shit. I'm sorry if I'm getting this wrong. I don't remember who it was. It was so long ago and it was very brief. But I lawyered up and they dealt with that and suppressed information that they received from Cloudflare because it wasn't relevant to the case. And Tomlinson never went after the Kiwi Farms again. So I consider that a success in our favor. I rack that up as a win. Not Legal Eagle. Nick Lowe's that guy. I don't know who it is then. I'm sorry. Can't be Eagle. Okay. Hold up. Let me pull up this is. Robert Barnes. Sorry if this man knows Legal Eagle and hates him and will never represent my interest in the state of... Michigan, I think. What state is he in? Ohio. I don't know. I hope I have not angered this man, because he did what I wanted. He got Tomlinson to fuck off. And so I've just been watching this case, and recently he dropped it voluntarily, which means one thing. He ran out of money. And from what I understand, his lawsuit was actually funded by the Sci-Fi Writers Guild. And for whatever reason, they've been taking their member dues and giving it to Tomlinson to fund this stupid-ass fucking lawsuit, which has no doubt racked up more than six figures of charges to the Sci-Fi Writers Guild on behalf of Tomlinson. And he owes the owner of Opie and Anthony Forums $23,000. Let me get the exact number, because the number is a meme with them, and I want to say the exact number so that... I can be cool and hip with the other crowd out there. He owes Quasi, the Opie and Anthony Forum owner, $23,739.25. So a quarter on top of that. $23,739.25 in legal fees to Quasi. And it's unknown how if he will be able to pay this money back to Quasi. So he's basically fucked, and it couldn't have happened to a nicer person, because much like Nader, I really get power and dominance, like control freak, serious, serious mental illness control freak vibes from this guy anytime I hear him talk. If you go on Twitter and you like search his tag, like geek something, and you like look at and you like search the term child, like he calls everyone a child. And I'm going to play about 10 minutes of this phone call. And he repeatedly talks down in like this weird, sadistic, almost like perverted sexual way to this guy he's talking to. It's really creepy. It's really and he mentions that he's going back to a party. So he gets this call, he walks out there, and he's like, child, why are you talking to me, child? You have no right to open your mouth when you have nothing to say to me, child. And he just goes on and on like this. That's not even exaggeration. That's literally what he says for 10 fucking minutes. And he's like outside a party, so no doubt his friends are hearing him say this shit, which is super creepy and really funny when you think about it. And I'm just glad he lost. I hope this guy's fucking bankrupt. I hope he's eating out of a trash can. He got divorced by his wife. He has no involvement in his daughter's life because he's a fucking loser. He's probably verbally and psychologically abusive to these women. So he has no right to be in their life because he's obviously a freak who should be far away from other people. And he's got bitch tits, but he likes to pretend that he's like some sort of martial arts, like 300 confirmed kills, U.S. Marine Corps officer, like Spectre. So they call him like pepperoni nipple, Patrick. They have a lot of nicknames. They really fuck with this guy, but he deserves it because he's an asshole. He's like the biggest asshole I can think of. Like compared to like Wings of Redemption or Dark Side Phil, this guy like. Seethes and exudes this horrific, like pompous, pretentious, cocky energy. It just makes you root against them. But you can go to apostlegate.net and listen to the Hosea tapes if you want to listen to all of it. We got to throw it on the forum. There's the onaforums.com, I think, the Open Anthony forums. If you want to talk to them, their site's not safe for work though. They have like porn avatars and shit, which doesn't jive on my squeaky clean. Clean fun forum, Karen forums. But I'm gonna play the second half of this because the first half is just the same exact exchange over and over again. But eventually, the troll, the setup is this guy talks to Patrick and says, "I'm from the Huffington Post and I want to do an interview about the cyber terrorism you're enduring." So they have about 2.5 hours of phone calls, and then suddenly he's like, "Oh shit, this might be a troll. I'm a fucking retard. I admit that I'm only doing this lawsuit to harass people." So he asked for confirmation, and the guy, I'll just play this actually. He says, I talked to my,
You probably fucked with my signal. So anyway.
Oh, okay. Can you hear me now?
I can. Yes.
Okay. I was just going to say that I spoke with my supervisor about getting in contact with you. She says that you're a fat faggot with bitch tits, so we're going to have to cancel the article.
Oh. Well, the problem with that, sweetie, is that we already figured that out.
He acts like that's immediately part of his plan. He talked to this guy for like 2 hours and 40 minutes because he just was so... He was actually trolling him. He was always in control. He can't lose control. Never him. He's always in control. It's like a psychotic thing where he can't admit... He can't take an L because it would like hurt him. But I'll play the second half and I'll interrupt it if I feel like I need to. Where was I at? Actually, it was like 4:30, wasn't it? Bam.
You misrepresented yourself from the beginning, which is a crime, by the way. You then used that to get information that you were not privy to because you were lying the entire time. That's also a crime. And you used shut your fucking mouth. You used that to continue furthering your obsessive criminal...
Dude, you're a mentally retarded fat faggot.
...against me and my family. Why are you still talking? You have never had a single fucking word to say, you sociopath.
Dude, you're drunk.
Why would you think you get to talk?
How much have you had to drink tonight, Patrick?
Why would you think you get to talk?
How much have you had to drink tonight?
Why would you think you get to talk? I don't...
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Of any importance or relevance to say. Never have.
Okay, so why isn't Sacha Baron Cohen in prison for doing the same exact thing?
There's no okay. This isn't a conversation. It never was. criminal activities. You only advanced the criminal case against you.
Okay.
Okay.
There
you go.
Feel free to feel free to show the Milwaukee Police Department prank call. I'll be happy to supplement that sending with an email where you sent me your phone number and gave me permission to call you, idiot.
This is why I skipped most of this, by the way, because what happens is that at the beginning, the guy is like too nice to him. He's being an asshole because he's fucking with him, but it's sort of like he'll talk to Patrick like a normal person, and then Patrick will be like, no, shut your mouth, child. Shut your mouth. If you have nothing to say to me, child, shut your mouth. And the guy will like be put off by this and will just shut up because it's like, what the fuck do you have to say? I'm interested to hear what you have to say about this. And he'll just like start rambling about nothing, and like the conversation will die for the most part because he'll just stop talking on his end. So eventually the guy on the other end starts just talking over him, and Patrick can't handle this. Like, psychologically, he has to be in control. He has to control the ebb and flow of the conversation. And once the other guy starts talking over him, and he loses that control, he really starts to like freak out at him.
Those are the facts of the case. Those are the facts of the case.
The facts of the case are you gave me your phone number and said I could call you, and I called you.
You misrepresented. It doesn't matter who you are. Shut your fucking mouth, you stupid little baby infant. You misrepresented.
Is this what you did to your school teachers every time they proved you wrong?
Shut your fucking mouth. You misrepresented who you are in order to falsely and fraudulently obtain information. That's what you did. That is a crime.
No, it isn't.
It does not match. Yes, child, it is.
What crime would that be?
It does not matter. Yes, child, it is.
It does matter.
It does matter.
It does matter.
I gave you
it does matter. It does matter, Patrick.
Shut your fucking mouth.
I will not shut my fucking mouth.
False pretenses. Shut your fucking mouth. Why do you think you get to talk? I don't understand why you think you have any right to talk to me in the first place.
Yo, shut the fuck up, you fat faggot.
It's truly bizarre. It's truly bizarre. Whatever mental health issues you have that you think that you get to treat complete strangers.
What are you drinking tonight?
Is something. No. Be quiet. Be quiet. The fact that you have such severe antisocial problems in your tiny little brain that you think you get to treat complete strangers you know nothing about this way says a million times more about everything that you have, all the deficiencies in you as a person, than it will ever say about anyone you have ever tried to fuck with. But you fucked with the wrong person. And now you're going to pay.
Yeah, I'm really scared, Patrick. You know, 3 years of telling me that I'm going to get arrested a matter of days, pretty much. That's what you've been saying. You know, actually, about a year ago, I asked you on Reddit.
Actually, you didn't ask me anything because you don't get to ask me questions.
Well, I did, and you answered. And I asked you, what's your new script going
to
be? Well, I asked you and you answered.
You don't get to ask questions, little one.
Well, you don't get to define reality, actually.
You don't get to ask me questions.
Okay, well, when the judge rules against you, you're going to really understand who's in charge, Patrick.
This is not a conversation, little one.
Dude, you're drunk as fuck, man. Stop drinking, stop eating so much, you idiot. Go exercise and see your daughter, you fat faggot.
Child, your mouth keeps doing that thing.
Yeah, I'm giving you good advice. That's probably what your conscience is telling you.
You need to get that looked at by a doctor.
You need to listen to your conscience, Patrick. Is your conscience telling you to go on Twitter all day? Or is it telling you to go have your daughter in your life and get a real job?
I'm just, like, he's one step away from saying, like, kitten. Like, kitten, daddy is not having a conversation right now. I am talking and you have nothing to say, kitten, baby child, sweet summer raisin pea. you listen while I speak to you.
And stop being obsessed with Twitter.
Little baby child, my conscience is clear. Yours
no, it isn't. I know that.
Is not. Oh, baby.
I highly doubt that. Really, your conscience tells you to have no contact with your daughter?
Baby, child, you doubt everything.
Why are you getting so uppity about that?
You have never believed a single true thing about me, my family.
That is a true thing.
My extended family, my friends, my colleagues. You've never believed a single true
thing. That's a true thing that you wrote, Patrick.
Shut your fucking mouth. Don't speak.
Yeah, that's what you tell your conscience, Patrick.
There's no way he's not like this to like his ex-wife or daughter. It is impossible for me to imagine he does not talk this exact same way when he's having a conversation with his ex-wife. I wonder why he's divorced. It's really a fucking mystery.
Speak. You have never believed a single true thing about me or anyone in any way tangentially associated with me. Everything your defective little group of sociopathic cultists tosses around as dogma is false. You can't separate your own delusions from reality anymore.
Dude, you're a fucking child, dude. Stop playing with fucking toys. Lose some weight.
No, nothing.
Get a real job.
I simply don't.
Get back with John and Adrian, get back in their good graces so you can see your daughter, dude. Quit it with this fucking bullshit.
That's not how any of this works.
You're not a victim. Nobody is trying to harass you.
It's none of your concern.
If you stopped being a fucking dickhead to everybody, people would stop fucking with you. No.
What you do is a fucking felony.
No, it isn't.
All of it.
No, it isn't.
It is a fucking felony. The fact you're calling me right now is a fucking felony.
No, it isn't.
The fact you're recording me right now.
You gave me your phone number, idiot.
Shut your fucking mouth.
Yeah, the judge isn't going to tell me that when I say that to him.
The judge is not involved here. The judge is not in this conversation. Because there isn't a conversation.
Well, guess what? You're not going to be able to say that to the police.
He had no way to segue that. He's like, the judge isn't in this conversation. And then his brain's ticking. Chink-chunk, chink-chunk. And he's trying to think of, like, because it won't go to court, because you'll just be arrested. Wait, no, that doesn't make sense, because there'd be a judge if he went to court. Oh, God, I've really boxed myself in. Wait. There's no conversation at all. That's why the judge isn't there. It's not that there won't be a judge. It's because this isn't a conversation, baby child.
When the police ask you, did you give this person your phone number? And you say, shut your fucking mouth. Guess what? They're not going to pursue your case.
Shut your fucking mouth. It's a really easy thing to do. You can just stop talking. You can just stop calling me. You can just stop.
Yeah, I can.
You can just stop.
Can you stop twittering?
You'll get really fucking lucky. Maybe you'll get lucky and not be identified and not be arrested.
I don't care about being identified.
The only chance you have.
You already identified me on that spreadsheet.
The only chance you have left.
Spoiler alert, I don't live in the U.S.
That's the only chance you have left in this world.
He completely ignores that, by the way. He doesn't, in his brain, he doesn't have oh God, this guy's not even American. How am I going to get him on cyber terrorism charge now? His brain has no answer for that, and he just completely avoids that point for the rest of the conversation.
Well, anyways,
you're still trying to talk and you don't get to. You're still trying to talk and you don't.
Yeah, because you're a narcissist, dude.
You have nothing.
Your mother fucked you up. Your mother told you that you're special. You have authority.
You have nothing.
You're an intellectual genius. You're smarter than everybody. You're special.
You have nothing.
And look where you are now, dude. You're $100,000 deep in legal fees. You're about to pay quasi $20,000. You're married to a lesbian. You can't see your daughter. You don't have a real job. Wow, I'm really jealous, Patrick. I should really get a life.
Told you what was happening, child.
Yeah, he told you he's going to uphold the quash unless you show a specific example.
Quasi's already out that money, child. The judge already told you that.
No, he's you're gonna be.
Yes.
He's retarded. What he's saying there, the Quasi's already out of that money. Yeah, that's like his legal expenses fighting the bullshit case, which you now owe him because he spent that much. You owe him that much money in legal fees because you made him spend that much to defend himself without merit.
Child,
ordered to pay him.
Really, should have listened to the hearing. You should have listened to the hearing. The judge already told you Quasi is not getting his money.
No, he didn't.
It's not happening.
Did not say
yes,
that.
Child, he did.
No, he didn't.
Is his
no, we have recordings of that, moron.
Is his wife actually a lesbian now? That's funny. That's funny. A lot of women, like, go gay after they deal with, like, a guy, and they're just like, fuck it, I'm done dealing with men. I'm tired of being called a baby child. I'm just gonna go butch.
Hear what the judge...
He never said Quasi is out of his money.
Yes, child, he did.
No, he
didn't. Listen to what... Yes, child,
you're gonna have to pay him.
Maybe your ADD or whatever the fuck is wrong with you made it so that you kind of wandered off or weren't paying attention, but the fact of the matter is, at the end of the last hearing, the judge already said, Quasi's not getting his money. He didn't use those words.
In this picture, the wife is in the lap. That is not Patrick that she's sitting in the lap of. That is Patrick on the left, the uncensored face. So, yeah... I don't know. Maybe he got cucked and that, like, broke his brain. So now he has to, like, act real narcissistic and indignant and, like, talk down to people constantly because he's, like, really butthurt. That's one possible theory.
So maybe it confused
you. Yeah, he didn't use those words. Okay. So that goes into your psychotic interpretation in your brain, Patrick.
No. You have a tiny little brain that has many, many things wrong with it, which is why you did this in the first place.
Dude, you cheated on that half marathon. You sent yourself that.
You
will never find me 14.
Because those sounds are meaningless and have nothing to say. There's no actual information contained within any of the little squeaks that come out of your pathetic little lips.
You sound so much like Peetz. That's that impotent tard rage where you can't just call someone a faggot because it would make you look bad by your own standards. So you just have to go, like, you don't know what words mean, and you are wrong, and your takes are very bad, and you have nothing to say.
You emailed yourself from You Will
Shut
Never Find Me 1488.
Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Good boy. Thank you for shutting the fuck up. Anyway, I'm ending
your Keep ruining your life, you stupid idiot. We're going to keep pointing and laughing at you.
You keep...
Pointing and laughing at you, yes.
Why. I can't conceive of why you think talking is in any way beneficial to you when you have nothing to say.
Trying to help
so
you,
I'm
Patrick.
Conversation now, and I'm going to go back in and continue having fun with all of my friends and my very
Oh, your friends.
Wife, and then we're going to go home and have a very good evening.
And she's going to
so,
fuck you in the ass.
Thank you very much. Go fuck yourself. No, that's not... I'm into things, but that's definitely not
he,
one of
He
them.
Was going to turn it off there... And then he pulled out, you got fucked in the ass and your wife told everyone that she pegged you. And then the call has to go on for another 3.5 minutes because he has to correct the record right then and there.
Yes, it is. You already said it was. She likes
no,
fuck. You like to get fucked in the ass, Patrick. No. Don't lie. You already admitted that.
No.
Yeah,
child,
yeah,
I didn't
yeah.
Say that.
Yeah, you
no,
did.
No, child, I didn't say that.
Yeah,
this
you
is
did.
One of those things that is a delusion that you hold.
You like to get
don't
fucked
understand
in the ass.
How other actual human beings work. You just don't understand things.
You like to get
you
pegged in the ass with, by your wife.
You are fundamentally
you faggot
as a person, and we both know it.
You're a gay
it's
faggot,
very,
dude. You like things in
yeah,
your
no,
ass.
Like, sweetheart, mentally healthy people don't act the way you do. They just don't.
I don't know why, but that line really made me laugh. You're a gay faggot. You like things in the ass. That's gay. Like, wow. Now that you put it like that, you're right. That is pretty gay.
Well, straight people
hobbies.
Don't like to get
they
fucked in the ass, Patrick.
Being, they have hobbies that don't include being a cyber terrorist against complete strangers. But that's what you do because you mistake cruelty for comedy because there's something fundamentally broken inside of you as a person.
This isn't how mentally stable people respond to prank calls, Patrick.
I can't help that for you. There's nothing I can do about that. And if I could, I wouldn't because you're a sociopath and I don't want to help you in any way. I want to see you stopped. I want to see you put in prison where you...
Exactly,
because
you're a narcissist. You have
yes,
these incredibly...
No,
delusional.
No, child, you keep doing the talking thing when you have nothing to say, and it's really tiring. I gotta tell you.
Dude, you clearly do not live a good life that anybody envies.
No, baby, child, you obviously don't, or you wouldn't act this way. That's just not how.
Why, doing prank calls?
Would act. No, you have nothing. That's why you're doing this on a Saturday.
Doing a 20-minute prank call?
That's why you're doing this on a Saturday night. Because you have no life. You have no one to go to. You have no one who cares about you.
Dude, you're fucking deranged.
Be with you. And I do, so guess what? We're just going to go ahead and end this pointless talk.
And you're going to get fucked in the ass by your wife.
You never had anything to say. No, child.
Yeah, you will.
No, child. Why does he talk like that? That last one.
Deranged.
Wants to be with you. And I do, so guess what? We're just going to go ahead and end this pointless talk.
And you're going to get fucked in the ass by your wife.
You never had anything to say. No, child.
Yeah, you will.
No, child.
You like
child.
To get.
Is he like British? Did he learn elocution from like a British woman? Like, what the fuck is that? Why does he talk like that? What happened? Is that like the feminization that happens after you get molested? Like, what the fuck breaks you that way to make you sound British when you're talking down to someone?
Fucked in the ass by your wife.
No.
Yeah.
Little
yeah.
Baby child.
Yeah.
No, child.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You do.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Believe in your delusions
you
because
go.
It's all you have left.
No, that's something
world.
You said, Patrick.
And
you
I
like to
am
get
going
fucked
to
in the
take
ass.
Those from you, too.
You're gonna
Good
take
night,
what?
You fucking abject coward.
You're a Jesus fucking fat Christ. Faggot.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are.
That's simply untrue. No, it's simply untrue, baby.
It's 40 more seconds. He does his big thing like, you are a loser and a degenerate and I am done. I'm off to have fun with my friends. And then the guy's just like, you're a faggot. He's like, actually, I'm not a faggot. I object to this child.
It's a delusion you hold. You, however, who hides, who never shares his name, never shares his face, doesn't use his real phone number because he's terrified of consequences.
No, it's because I live in another country and I deal with long-distance phone calls if I gave you my real phone number.
Yeah, you're just mumbling. It's pathetic. Good night.
I'll give you my real phone number, actually. 0995. I already hung up.
So that's the Patrick call. Patrick Tomlinson, in case you're interested, there's a supercut of every time he says child in that call, and it's still like 5 minutes just by itself, in case you're interested in that. There is one more clip, and then I'm out. This is a 2 minutes of Peetz being angry, and we'll listen to this. Somehow I missed this. Someone pointed this out, so we'll watch it just to round out. I don't want to, because I'll never get a chance to play this again. Peetz wrote a fanfic a while back, like years and years ago, on fanfic.net or some shit, archive of our own, whatever that site is. And it was a rape I think I read a page of it even, and it was like a rape fanfic of like X-Men incest where like a frogman like tongue punches some chick in the vagina. At orders of like a villain, so he wrote like rape fanfic, like what is it, like porn. There's like a special word for like porn fanfic, but he wrote one of those and it got found out, and it caused a big stink, and he had to do his apologies for being a creepy weirdo, and someone called him a erotica, right? So then someone calls him a rape apologist in the stream where he's bitching about per capita, and he goes off about that. So we'll listen to that.
No. Katie Marie, just fuck off. Go fuck it. You know, Katie Marie, one more shit comment and I'm just blocking you, okay? Last chance. Like one chance here. Shut the fuck up, or I'm just gonna straight up blocking you. Because you're fucking and you're getting on my fucking nerves. You have nothing worthwhile to say, so shut the fuck up, or I've shut you up.
Welcome to Ban World.
Can we just have a casual conversation? Apparently not, because people are being fucking assholes here.
Sounds like something a rape apologist would say. Look, he's blocking someone. He's touching the mouth.
Yeah, fuck you, Katie Marie. Just fuck off. Just go the fuck away. Stay off my fucking channel. Never come back. You're a fucking idiot. You're an asshole. You're a prick who's just trying to piss me off. So just fuck off, you stupid fucking shitty troll.
He can't say bitch. He wants to call her a bench and a cunt. He's like, you stupid cunt. I hope you get fucking buried alive. Fuck you. But he can't. He's restrained by... Look at the grimace on his face. He's like actually clenching his teeth in frustration. How dare this woman speak to me when she has nothing to say, child.
Stop it. Like, just all you fucking trolls, just fuck off. Christ. What did she say? A whole lot of bullshit. She said absolutely nothing but bullshit. Possible talk about politics without losing your shit? It's hard to do that when people are accusing me of being fucking rape apologist. So fuck you to everyone who's ever accused me of being a rape apologist, by the way. Everyone who's ever said that, fuck off, go to hell. Racism promoting pedophilia? Fuck you, Herbie. Go fuck yourself, you asshole. How fucking dare you? How the fuck dare you? Fuck you, Internet T.
That's good. Oh, I have one more clip. I have one more clip. This one's short. Shout out, Sean Ranklin. Big ups, Liquid Richard.
Another guy up top.
Another guy up top. I'm coming. God, near me. No, I didn't say the damn N-word.
Say it again.
Go along with that.
Replay.
Did I say the N-word just now? Did you hear that?
God, nigger me. Near me. Near me. God, nigger me. Near me. Near me.
God, nigger me. Near me. Near me.
It's so obvious he knows he said it too, because he says near me twice after, like immediately after. He's like, oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. He's like sweating. He knows. He heard it himself. He can't deny it. It came out. It just slipped on out all natural like. Peaceful life of a streamer. I don't know what it is. I've been on a Wings of Redemption like tear on the last couple weeks. I've been like listening to this guy called Wings 007 put together like a montage of all the Wings stuff from 2021. It's like an hour long video. If you want like a Wings update since my last stream on him, like, which is like in 2020, he did, he had the surgery and he gained all the weight back somehow. He got married to a woman. And she's very frumpy, but she's, like, in his, like, you know, she's probably out of his league, to be fair. But she's very funny. She's, like, a very funny woman. Anytime she's on stream, she's cracking jokes, and she's, like, playing fun on the trolls and stuff. And, like, he gets mad at her, and is like, can you get out of here? I'm going to get real competitive here. I'm playing Call of Duty. And she's like, oh, you're sending me to Ban World? You're swatting me out of the room? And he's, like, getting upset. He's getting flustered that she's, like, cracking jokes at his expense, and he can't take it. It's like, no, really, I mean it. I'm getting competitive over here. You got to get out. And she's like, okay, whatever, dude, and leave. She's really funny. He should learn to let her just take the reins of the stream and make jokes, because everyone seems to love her. Yeah, he's not as bad as he was before in terms of like being a whiny sourpuss, but he hasn't really improved all that much either, which is kind of sad, because his trolls are like shitty people, and they're a lot of them are criminals now, and it's just like, I'm kind of rooting for him, but at the same time, he's not learning, so it's kind of hard to like say, well, you know, go for it. But I would definitely suggest the Wings 007 hour long video if you want to get like a wrap up of the entire week of or entire year of 2021 and Wings of Redemption. Pretty good channel overall. The others are kind of like shitty, but Sean Ranklin is inactive. And don't forget to hit like. All right. Hardman working hard. New song. Apologize. It's 5 minutes long, but it's been a very long stream, so I guess I'm justified in playing that. I will see you guys next week, but there's a big but. I have sent out, I have personally invited Chantal to have an interview, a conversation with me. So if she decides to accept that, which she probably will not, I might stream sooner than Friday to talk to her. So, wow. Oh, my God. The chat. I'm not even going to read the chat. I'm ignoring such vile troll comments on my channel. I rebuke it in the name of the Lord. See you guys. Want to see you. Bye-bye. And check out the website. It's now Maddie. Oh, my God. Before I forget, all the coin orders have gone out. All of them have gone out. So check, go to Maddie.live. That'll take you to the site, and then go to Silver Updates and read that page if you're waiting for your silver. I'm going to have to send out an email, so expect that. If you're missing your order, I have a couple extra to fill in blanks. But, oh my God, it's the home stretch. I can't fucking believe it. It feels like it's been going on for literally a year now. I cannot wait to be done with this. And there might be a couple left. I'm not, like, I mean, there could be a lot of missing coins, but... who knows? Okay, see you guys on CPAP. Bye-bye. Apologize. All you gotta do is cry and apologize. All they want from you is to apologize. Head down to the ground, dust to the sky. Kiss the ring, quick down, won't say it twice. Quite the scene you've made, do you feel pride? Everybody stopped watching you all lies. Speak the worst thing about and say I'm right. Now rise, it's time to apologize. Take back all the lies and apologize. Put the cringe online, think it wouldn't mind. Down bad, so you're mad in the replies. Let it all for the clout and the quick likes. Every sneeze you've sown will reap price. Max cook, doing damage to your hairline. Take it back, there's a chance if you do it right. Now rise, it's time to apologize. In all your lies, look me in the eyes. Feeling, I don't believe it. Get down on your knees now and scream it. Apologize for all your crimes. Look me in the eyes now and mean it. Scream it, I don't believe it. On your hands and knees till you're bleeding. Apologize for all your ties. Look me in the eyes now and mean it. You're bleeding, I don't believe it.
Make a man.